Hello, welcome to Samachar Live. I am Divyam, the host for today. We have a guest for today, Eminence General Secretary, Mrs. Shalini Thackeray. Hello, ma'am. Welcome to Samachar Live, ma'am. So, ma'am, as you are always coming up with women-related issues, like issues on women's safety, like you are providing employment to women of very low-level areas. Also, you have come up with many women-related schemes also, which you are always suggesting. So I would like to ask you first question that do you support feminism or do you support gender equality? What are your views on feminism?
When we talk about women issues, I think everybody mistakes us or thinks that we are talking about feminism. I am not against any feminist or feminist issues, but when I talk about, for me, nobody is down or up. For me, everybody is equal. Everybody on this birth, on this earth has been born equal. So for me, the issue is of gender equality. Gender equality with regards to women. Because I think we all understand that this is a male-dominated society. We have been brought up that way in all these decades. Every woman has been brought up that way. We are told that we are women power. We are told that we are object of worship. But when it actually comes down to ground level, the Never. Kind of treatment that women are given and the kind of environment that women are given, is very lacking. So yes, I am talking about gender equality.
Ma'am, we have seen that though there are so many schemes related to girls' education, but still at current era, girls are not getting that educated, especially the girls who are raised in poor families or the families who don't have fathers or somebody who can stand for them. So government is actually not doing anything about them. So how do you think that girls' education can be promoted in those areas?
See, definitely on paper we have a lot of schemes.
Yeah.
I think this government has a very big campaign of beti
beti
padhao, beti bachao, beti padhao.
Yeah.
That is the big campaign that is given to all of, it comes in front of all of us. But as you yourself said, that how much do we reach the women or our daughters get the benefit of all these yojanas? All these years, I'm not going to be targeting any particular government on this. I think all these years, whether it was the earlier government or it's this year, this government, everything remains on paper. Nothing reaches the people that it is supposed to reach. Here I am going to be talking more about the women. Our daughters are told that they should be given the education. But when it actually comes down, have we created that environment which we help them get the education? Just by saying that we are not you going to charge you any fees for the school does not make the environment to get them educated.
Right.
Today, if a household has to make a choice between educating their son or their daughter, they will always choose their son.
Right.
They will not give the education to their daughter because of financial constraints. Today, you have an environment where unemployment has increased. Today you have an environment where our daughters are not safe, so the house does not want to send them outside. Mm. Today we have an environment where we are not looking into the health issues of our daughters. Mm. There is a major dropout rate. They immediately, as soon as our daughter gets free periods, they leave school.
Yeah.
That we are not making any environment friendly for them to continue education. Today, if the choice is between a girl has to go and get a water from into the house, or a son has to get, who do you see on the streets getting water into the house? It's the daughter, not the son. So we still have a very long way to go before we actually reach the stage where we say that our daughters are getting the required education that they are supposed to get, because it requires a lot of changes in the environment in which our daughters are raised.
So
it cannot be just a simple thing ki beti padhao beti bachao. Ab beti padhane ke liye aap kya kya kar rahe hain, what are the steps you are taking for so that your daughter will get educated. We need to take all those steps, and that is related to a lot of other environmental factors, as I have brought to your notice.
Just like educating parents before the daughters get educated.
That is one of the things. Awareness is one of the things. Yeah. But having made the awareness, even then when that step has to be taken, we still haven't given them that support.
Right. Ma'am, we see that gender discrimination is seen everywhere, including workplaces, whether it is job opportunity, a vacancy, or promotion, or salary. There is a huge discrimination made between a male and a female. So, what do you think? How can this gap can be reduced?
Definitely, I agree with you that there is gender discrimination. That is where this whole gender equality issue arises from, and it leads to gender discrimination.
Yeah.
At workplaces, in terms of salaries, in terms of opportunities, we have a discrimination issue. Our constitution does not state that.
Yeah.
Our constitution does not state that there has to be a different rules and opportunities for women and a different for men. It does not state that. It is our environment which is doing that. When it comes to opportunities, equal opportunities, they say are given to men and
right.
women, which is not the mm-hmm. case. The opportunities available to men are much more than they are for women. I think this is all a part of the process that we are all fighting for. When we are fighting for women, it entails every aspect. It entails the opportunities, it entails the health and hygiene, it entails education. So, yes, I agree that there is gender discrimination, but nothing is being done about it. Minimum Wages Act does not say that the wages that are given to men and wages that are given to women is different. It states that there is equal,
yeah.
but when down the line, when actually the wages are given, the scales are different.
Right.
So now it is ultimately how serious is our governance to take action about this? How serious is our governance to give the same opportunities to women? It all arises from that. It will have to be done on a policy level, which we are all fighting for.
So, women, So, ma'am, coming to next question is, how much do you support women reservation? And if you support it, then in which areas you think it should be there, and how much percentage should be there?
Frankly, if you're asking me, I do not support any reservation. I do not support any kind of reservation, be it on the basis of gender, on the basis of religion, on basis of caste. I feel if there has to be a reservation has to be on the basis of economic and financial stability. The somebody who needs it should get the reservation on the basis of the economic status. Sometimes you do not have the financial strength to be able to make use of the opportunity.
Right.
Those people should be given special reservation to make use of the opportunity. So I'm against reservations. But having said that, in certain areas, in certain places. I do support women's reservation because, as I said earlier, women do not get the same opportunities. So to make use of opportunities, these reservations to some extent are required. Example, if I have to give you, I'll give you of my field. I think that women make very good administrators, women make very good, women will be able to really do much more sincere work in the community, in their area than men. I totally believe that.
Right.
But because for this, the reservation is required to get more women to get involved in fields like politics.
Right.
Today, the number of women in politics is very less.
Mm.
And I think there are a lot of other fields in which women are not coming forward because of the kind of, the environment is not friendly. But I feel that to make them come forward, women reservations are required, that we have the 50% women reservations for contesting elections till the BMC and in the Mahanagar Palikas and the Jilla levels, but we do not have reservations in the state level
upper levels.
We do not have in the center. So you see, the number of women contesting is very low.
Yeah.
So when you have to make these kind of opportunities available, you need women reservations. To that extent, I do support, but I again say that I am not in favor of reservations.
Ma'am, you have a very large, a huge followers base, and we would, because of International Women's Day, I would like to ask you that, what is your message to your fan followers?
I first of all would like to wish all women happy Women's Day. For me, every day is a Women's Day. I think women from morning till night work for their families, work for their areas, work for their state, work for their country. Every day they are contributing without expecting anything. So for me, every day is a Women's Day, and I would only try to get everybody's attention to the fact that it is very important to keep a woman happy. If a woman is happy, she will keep her house happy, and if the house is happy, the state will be happy, the country will be happy, and that is what is the requirement and the need of the hour. So I really think that we all should come together and try to make certain things and opportunities available so that our women are kept happy. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you for giving us your precious time. And thank you to Shalini Thackeray, ma'am, for giving her interview, giving her insights to us, so that we can follow, we can try our level best to keep our women happy on this International Day. We would like to send her message to all her fan followers, including men and women. Thank you.